If you can meet any character from a movie or TV show, who would you meet? My dad asks. Easy. Willy Wonka to get his chocolate recipe, my little sister responds. Hermione Granger from Harry Potter, my mom adds. As for me, it would have to be the genie from Aladdin, for obvious reasons. The table bursts into a heated discussion. Me and my mom on one side, and my dad and my sister on the other. That was one of my family's most recent dinner table conversations. As my family and I sit down to enjoy our meal, we begin our daily routine. We unplug from the outside world to engage in conversations. Our chatting might include crazy stories, exciting activities, mess-ups, and more. This has been the one constant for most of my life. Eating together is a small act, and it requires very little of us. 45 minutes away from our usual daily distractions to engage in conversations. But yet, this has invariably been one of the most happiest parts of my day. These have fostered my compassion, my love for learning, and taught me to become more outspoken. The dinner table is a unifier, a place of community. When I would come home from school and my mom would ask me and my sister how school was, we would be guilty of responding in one-word answers. School was boring, school was the same, but after these dinner table conversations, she said that she's gotten to know more about mine and my sister's lives and what was going on and get past these monosyllable responses. At one of our family dinners, a young me asked, "What is the government?" That opened a whole Pandora's box of questions. But ever since then, my dad has updated my sister, my mom, and I every single day on the news at the dinner table. It was like having my own Anderson Cooper right in front of me. At the table, my precocious sister always keeps conversations lighthearted with her elementary school adventures, weird but true facts, and Mandarin. Was I true one fun? I'm eating dinner, she says, and I recite after her. I find Mandarin challenging, but I recite after her anyway, and after a few of these dinners, I have finally picked up enough pieces to manage my way around our local Chinatown. I'd go to bed each day with the new knowledge that I had just learned from my parents and sister, which they had gathered from their colleagues and teachers. I would feel proud of all of the new knowledge I had just gathered. How stocks work, what bills were being passed in Congress today, and how to speak a basic conversation in Chinese, all in a day's work. I absorb more here than I could ever from a textbook or article. My dinner table conversations have helped shape the person who I am today. Family dinners became a communal gathering where each family member contributed a different story to be heard. For the majority of the day, we would all be engaged with school, work, and other engagements that we wouldn't have enough time to spend with one another. But these family dinners were the one time a day where we would all come together and share about our days and what we learned in the past 24 hours over a home-cooked meal. In a recent study, 90% of participants said that family was the most meaningful thing in life to them. But in contrast, only 50% of the participants said that family dinners were eaten together. We need to change these alarming statistics. According to a study by Stanford University, the dinner table is the perfect opportunity to build self-esteem in young children. By listening to what children have to say, you're saying, "I value what you do and say, I respect you, and what you do is important to me." Social interactions and discussions about current issues at the table can lead to improved communication skills. Because at the table, kids learn when to speak, how to listen to others, conduct conversations, and become more outspoken. It has actually been proven that there's a link between the number of times a child has meals with their family and their grades. Yes, mealtime discussions can actually translate into success in the classroom. This is because they expand their vocabulary while talking and learn to comprehend, which can lead to higher academic performance. In addition, the stress of school and work can also be mitigated with quality family time, so it can lead to better mental health overall as well. We all either eat breakfast, lunch, or dinner, And while it may not always be possible to sit down and have a long, relaxed meal with one another every day, even carving out 5 to 10 minutes every day to talk about what you learned in the past 24 hours with your family can be very, very beneficial. If every day isn't possible, you can set aside one day a week to all come together. And if your family is spread out across the country or the continent, you can even do a weekly Zoom and share a meal, and that could have the same impact. Family dinner doesn't have to be home cooked, and it doesn't have to be the last meal of the day. It just has to be together. Whether it's inviting your friends over for a potluck or making your parents breakfast in bed, this is the first step to making a conscious effort to do the simple but profound habit and reap the benefits that dinner table conversations have to offer.